A goy came up to Rabbi Moshe to ask, "Why do rabbis always answer with a question?" To which Rabbi Moshe replied, "Why not?" The night sky above Manhattan will never win any awards. The few stars visible looked lonely and desperate. I could relate. Sometimes the line between salvation and damnation is a mighty fine one. I no longer knew which side I stood on. There are those who would say that I had no business being here. They might be right. I am no longer sure what I'm doing. But I'm fairly sure I know who I am. Welcome to Let's Play the Shivah. I'm the RPG chick. I am playing this blind, meaning I've never played it before. I do know some things about the background of the game, so I'd like to share that with you really quickly. This was originally released in 2006. It was the first game ever developed by... The music's kicking in now. I never heard this part. The first game ever released by Wadjet Eye Games. And they've released many since then. This is their shortest and their first. They're probably most known for the Blackwell Legacy games, of which there are five. But there's plenty other games that they released as well. I plan on getting to a bunch of those. As they're fairly well received, and this game won several awards. Originally released on 2006. I can't talk. In 2006, re-released in 2013 with better graphics and music and re-recorded voiceovers. So other than that, yeah, this is going to be another short one. And options. You can't even make the game full screen in here. I had to do it through a separate, you know, configure a setup tool. This kibitz mode is like commentary. Warning, it is strongly suggested that you play through the game through at least once before activating kibitz mode, the commentary, as many plot details will be given away ahead of time, so we're not going to be using that. And subtitles are going to be on. Oh, it does have sound and voice sliders. Or sound and speech. I might put the speech down a tiny bit more, even. Achievements? I'm the best at what I do, because I haven't done anything. And bloopers, I guess I'll look after everything. So, new game. It began, as many things do, with a song. Now, I am not Jewish, though I have many friends who are. And all I know about Shiva is it's basically a memorial for a close family member who's passed away, like a member of a nuclear family. And it's called Sitting Shiva, which is basically like a week-long celebration or something like that. And family members, guests come every day, that kind of thing. The only reason I know anything about that, I think, would be from Babylon 5 with, the character of Susan Ivanova. Her brother passed away in battle, in a war, I believe. Not completely sure about that. I know it was fighting enemy forces of some kind. He wanted to sit Shiva with her. And he was on Earth, and she was light years away on the station Babylon 5. Anyway, they... has nothing to do with this game, but I'll just say they ended up doing it like over a video conference kind of thing because, you know, and they did what they had to. So that's how I know about Shiva. And that's why I love Babylon 5. Continuing.
Adon Olam Asher Malach Baterem Ko Yitzir Nivra Lied Nasa V'chel Tzokol Atzai Melech Shemo Nikra.
No idea what that was. His final note faded off into the near empty synagogue, unheard by anyone. as I had hundreds of times before this, I got ready to speak. And as I had hundreds of times before this, I began to wonder why. Sleeping.
Thank you, Cantor Kaplan. Today in my sermon, I'd like to discuss suffering. Why do bad things happen to good people? Wherever there is pain or oppression or poverty, the question is always the same. How could God let this happen?
Indeed.
Is God as good as we think? Can he, in fact, do evil? Maybe, on occasion, he even enjoys inflicting pain.
How could you sleep standing up like that? I took a good, hard look around my world. And then it hit me.
No. I can't do this. I'm sorry.
Rabbi?
You heard.
Huh? What?
Go home, Mrs. Raymer.
Is it over already?
She was the one sleeping.
Rabbi Stone, wait! You can't just stop.
Sure I can. Just watch me.
Oops!
But...
it's over, Josh.
What a badass.
You can't mean that.
Look, you're a good kid. You've got a good voice and a good future. Don't let me hold you back. Now do a mitzvah and call Mrs. Raymer a cab. Goodbye, Josh.
I thought it was Josh standing there sleeping. Ethical dilemmas have plagued religious leaders since the dawn of time. But morals don't mean crap without the personal experiences to back them up. Knock knock. Okay. Declare your intentions.
Leave me alone.
Well, that didn't work. State the obvious. I thought to give the brush office. Leave me alone.
Services are canceled.
Well, this person's determined. Give me the brush off now.
Go away.
Well. Restate the obvious.
I repeat, services are canceled.
Oh, God. At least answer him. Don't just knock like a fool. Stronger brush off.
I said, go away.
Someone's gotta get a beating. Redeclare your intentions.
Leave me alone, I said.
How did I guess? More knocking.
Fine, I'm coming.
Nah. Before that, let's look around the room. I have a diploma. It was fine where it was. Poster, okay. There was nothing up there I wanted to see. Crawl space. So I can't actually read these things? Move your mouse to the top of the screen to access. Oh, I have stuff. I have a business card and a Yiddish dictionary, and I have options, which is that. Rabbi Russell Stone, B'nai Ben Zion, 190 Essex Street, New York, New York, rstone@ravnetnewyork.com. By the way, guys, if I butcher pronunciations of Jewish things, especially holy things, I'm very sorry. I do not speak the language. Nothing of that. Yiddish dictionary, common Yiddish words, meshuga, crazy, mensch, a helpful person, momzer, bastard, son of a bitch, nebbish, weakling, shiva, period of mourning, shiksi, non-Jewish woman, yenta, a busybody, and goy, a non-Jewish person. That's it? That's not a very big dictionary, but, well, this is a small game. Someone was at the door. I couldn't futz with the computer now. Window? It wasn't the kind that opened. I wanted to look out the window. Oh wait, if I hit the other mouse button... Okay, the window afforded me the thrilling view of the deli across the street. Alright, let's try it on these. My diploma from B'nai B'rith Yeshiva.
Has it really been 30 years?
Didn't expect them to talk right now. Poster? I had come across this quote some years ago and had decided to have it printed and mounted on the wall. It read, "If statistics are right, the Jews constitute but 1% of the human race. It suggests a nebulous, dim puff of stardust lost in the blaze of the Milky Way. Properly, the Jew ought hardly to be heard of, but he is heard of, has always been heard of." Mark Twain, 1899. Certificate. My Certificate of Rabbinical Studies. It reads, "This is to certify that Russell Elias Stone has been granted the title of Rabbi by B'nai B'rith Yeshiva on the date of June 23rd, 1970. Good year. Josh picked this computer up at a local yard sale. He said it would revolutionize my life. That hadn't happened yet, but I wasn't holding my breath. A small crawl space used to store old records. Alright, so we got a computer. Anything else here? No. Photograph. Let's find where it was. So I'm guessing the left mouse button is to pick up or move items. And the right mouse button is to look at. A color photograph of B'nai Ben Zion Youth Group Picnic. It was taken over 15 years ago. Most of those kids probably had families of their own by now. Papers. They're fine where they are, let me guess. What was I going to do with them? Pay them? Just bills. Lots of them. Boxes. These boxes contained a small supply of Kiddush wine. As much as I would have loved to break open a bottle of Kiddush wine, I didn't think it was appropriate. There was nothing on the bookshelf I wanted to read. My collection of rabbinical texts, prayer books, Judaic history, and Harry Kimmelman novels. Anything else? Papers. Stuff. More stuff. What? Is this another computer? We have two? Alright, because it disappears and comes back, computer. Never mind. Alright, so that's it, really. Alright, I guess we'll go the way out. Gonna answer the door, finally. Come on in, so I can beat the hell out of you.
I told you to go home.
Rabbi Stone, there's someone here.
Oh, goody.
Tell him to get lost. There's no service tonight.
No, it's a cop.
Ta-da! Oh.
Detective Sam Durkin, Midtown South Precinct. Could I talk to you for a few minutes, Rabbi Stone?
Sarcastic response, poker face response, and rabbinical response. I can't. You always go for sarcasm. Always. That's a rule.
It's a free country.
It's my rule.
Yeah. Everyone's a comedian. Can you talk or not?
Fine.
That's a complicated
Josh,
question.
Take a hike.
Nice. Take a hike.
So, what can I do for you? I assume you're not here to convert.
Mm-hmm. Are you familiar with a Mr. Jack Lauder?
Should I be?
I'm asking the questions, Rabbi.
Fine. Let me think. Lauder.
Accessing memory files.
Oh.
Accessing.
You know him?
Yeah.
What can you tell me about him?
He used to belong to this congregation.
Data found.
Used to. But not anymore?
No. Left about 8 years ago, I think. What's this about?
Have you had any contact with him since?
No, I haven't. Care to fill me in here?
Do you read the papers?
I'm not going to be aggressive with a cop. What's the rabbinical response?
Who has the time?
So, you're not aware, Rabbi Stone, that Jack Lauder has been dead for 3 days.
Yeah, like I was totally putting on an act this whole time, wondering what the hell this is about when I actually knew he's been dead. Right. I did my best to control myself. I knew this man's type. His eyes scanned my face like a barcode reader, trying to read every telltale sign of emotion. Any flicker, any twitch could be used against me later.
No.
Does that bother you?
Should it?
Answer me, Stone.
No.
So you and Mr. Lauder weren't close?
No, we weren't. What's the deal, Durkin?
Yeah, Durkin.
I've seen Lauder's will. He left you a significant amount of money.
For healing. So I have the right to not twitch, and he left me money. I am incredulous, so I'll give an incredulous response.
He did what?
You heard.
How much?
I don't have the exact amount, but somewhere in excess of 10,000.
Nice.
Bull.
It's the truth.
Jack wouldn't give me bubkis, let alone $10,000.
And why is that, Rabbi Stone?
He just wouldn't.
We don't know him that well. No smoking.
This temple's in pretty sad shape, isn't it, Rabbi?
Well, you're not blind, that's for sure.
Can you afford the repairs?
I guess I can now. What's the rabbinical response?
Do I look like I can afford it?
I'm just asking.
Oh, you're just asking? Well, I'm going to ask you to leave. Mm. Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Rabbi Stone.
Get out of my office.
Listen.
No, you listen.
I like this guy.
I know where this is going, and I don't like it.
I'm just doing my job.
Yeah, you're a real mensch. Get out of here.
Fine. I'll leave, Rabbi Stone. But I'll be back.
Yeah, I bet you will.
This guy's a badass. I like him. The rabbi, I mean. Oh yeah, you gotta puff one more time then leave?
Putz.
Putz. The rain beat in a regular staccato rhythm against the window. But I could only hear one thing. Ka-ching! No. Jack Lauder. Jack Lauder. The name pulled out a cork in my brain, letting loose old thoughts and memories that fought and struggled for supremacy. Sounds messy. Jack Lauder. It was more than just a name. It was a link to a time when things were simpler. A time when I thought I had it all figured out. A time when morals and ethics meant something. A time before it all turned to crap.
I need to think.
Yes, you do. Can we look at the computer now? Josh set this computer up a few weeks ago. He claimed I needed to join the 21st century and connect with the community. Josh has been bugging me to start using it. I suppose now is as good a time as any. If only I could remember what Josh chose as my login and password. Probably Mensch or Meshuggah or something like that. Ravnet, New York, where Jews connect. This is not my username, this is... There's no user with the login Mensch. How am I supposed to know what it is? There's gotta be a hint in the office. I wanna read... Nah, not the poster this time. Rabbi? Russell Elijah Stone? Wait, actually...
Has it really been...
Where did I see something like an email address? Didn't mean to go back in there yet. Wait. That's right. It's on his business card. R. Stone. Duh. He's not good with this stuff. Password. Clue. Busybody. Mensch, right? Alright, we gotta look at it in our encyclopedia. Or Yiddish dictionary. Busybody. Yenta. What was that, a different password next time? Hello, Rabbi Russell Stone. Please choose an option below. Joke. Moshe was talking to his psychiatrist. I had a weird dream recently, he said. I saw my mother, but then I noticed she had your face. I found this so worrying that I immediately awoke and couldn't get back to sleep. I just stayed there thinking about it until 7 a.m. I got up, made myself a slice of toast and some coffee, and came straight here. Can you please help me explain the meaning of my dream? The psychiatrist kept silent for some time, then said, "One slice of toast and coffee? Do you call that a breakfast?" Martin Lewis converts and becomes a priest. He gives his first mass in front of a number of high-ranking priests who came for the occasion. At the end of the new priest's sermon, a cardinal goes up to congratulate him. "Pastor Lewis," he said, "that was very well done. You were just perfect. But next time, please don't start your sermon with fellow Goyim." Medical experts from London have published a paper that concludes that Seder participants should not eat both chopped liver and charosis. I don't even know what that is. Their research shows that if they do, they can lead to charosis of the liver. Moshe walks into a post office to send a package to his wife. The postmaster said, "This package is too heavy. You'll need another stamp." Moshe replies, "And that should make it lighter?" Alright, just a few more guys. I don't know how many are loaded in here. Howard, a young gay man, telephones his mother. "Mom, I decided to go back into the closet. I've met a wonderful girl and we're going to be married. What do you think of this news? You'll be happier now. I know that my gay lifestyle has been very disturbing to you." She responds, "I'm very glad, Howard. I suppose it wouldn't be too much to hope that she's a Jewish girl." Howard replies, "Not only is she Jewish, Mom, but she comes from a wealthy Beverly Hills family." "So what's her name?" the mother asks. "Monica Lewinsky," replies Howard. Oh, God. There was a pause, then his mother asks, "What happened to that nice black boy you were dating last year?" "Right?" "Good idea, Mom. Good looking out. A rabbi took a job at a Duracell factory. His job is to stand on the production line and, as the batteries go by, say, 'I wish you long life.'" Sadie tells Maurice, "You're a schmuck. You always were a schmuck, and you always will be a schmuck. You look, act, and dress like a schmuck. You'll be a schmuck until the day you die." Sadie continues, "And if they ran a worldwide competition for schmucks, you would be the world's second biggest schmuck." "Why only second place?" Maurice asks. "Because you're a schmuck," Sadie screams. A rabbi and a minister decide to buy a new car together. The day after they bought it, the rabbi found the minister driving it. The minister explained that he had just gone to the car wash because, in his religion, it is customary to welcome a new member with the rite of baptism. The next day, the minister discovered the rabbi cutting the end off the tailpipe. Oh, God. Yeah, circumcision. Moshe's mother, Hetty, once gave him two sweaters for Hanukkah. The next day Moshe visited his mother, he made sure he was wearing one of them. As he entered her house, instead of the expected smile, Hetty said, "What's the matter, Moshe? You didn't like the other one?" Alright, a few more. These are funny, and they're not long, so. Ben Levy was in a hospital ward with two non-Jews. On his first morning, Ben puts his tefillin around his arm, but the non-Jews can't figure out what he's doing. Finally, one says to the other, "Look how smart those Jews are. He's taking his own blood pressure." Sully took his King Charles Spaniel dog to the vet. "Dr. Cohen," he said sadly, "I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to cut off my dog's tail." Dr. Cohen stepped back in shock. "Sully, why would I do such a terrible thing?" "Oy vey, my mother-in-law is arriving tomorrow, and I don't want anything to make her think she's welcome." Yep, repeating. One more. Yep, looked like they go all in order. Okay. Mail. From Admin. Welcome to Ravnet. Welcome to Ravnet, New York. The newest way to bring Jews together as a community. Our features are small but growing. Here's a list of what we currently offer. The mail feature allows you to send and receive email. Oh, goody. The search feature allows you to search our data archive of Jewish news, events, and members. Everyone needs a laugh. Check out our joke feature for the best in Jewish jokes. On behalf of myself and the entire Ravnet team, thank you for joining and making our community stronger. Test. It's from Josh. Hello, Rabbi Stone. I set up your account for you. Hopefully it'll work out okay for you. You can change the password if you want. Most people choose things like their mother's or their wife's maiden name, but I thought this was appropriate. Haha. Cantor Josh. Mensch. I had it right. No, it wasn't Mensch. It was the other thing. It was the other thing I put, which I can't remember, because I'm not familiar with these words. From L. Schwartz. Shocked. Cheapmail.com. Lisa Schwartz. Dear Rabbi Stone, I have been a long, loyal member of B'nai Ben Zion for many years, but I can't bring myself to listen to your dark and gloomy sermons any longer. Times are tough enough for us Jews without you rubbing salt in the wound. Goodbye. Lisa Schwartz. Oh, damn. So much for loyalty. Dave at WadjetEyeGames.com. Great games. Okay. For the best in games and entertainment. You see right there, guys, if you want to view, go visit that site. It's actually a valid website. I went there myself to see what other games they have made. JBrooks@Hotmail.com. What happened? Rabbi Stone, but I'm sorry, but my family and I can't attend your services any longer. Your last few sermons have upset the children so much that it took several hours to calm them down. What happened to you? Jeremy Brooks. Search. Can I search it myself? Stone. Okay, just gives me an address. Contact information. What about Josh? No entries for Josh. Schwartz. Schwartz Kaplan. No one can resist the power of the Schwartz. No entries. Kaplan? With a K. So, I guess we have people we need to be in here. Alright, I'm logging out. That was illuminating. Alright, now what? Can we go in the crawl space now? Nothing up there. I guess we're done in here. I like the music.
Wow, Rabbi. What was that all about?
The detective had some questions for me.
Oh, yeah,
that's
that.
All.
So who was killed?
Josh. What did I tell you about listening at my door?
He's a Joshua
I kid. Wasn't, Rabbi, honest. You were just very loud. So who was killed? Was it that Lauder guy?
Oh, I need to look up Lauder. Rabbinical response.
Do you think so?
Yeah. Who else could it be? I heard you talking about him.
We must have talked very loud.
Well, yeah. So who is he?
An old member of this congregation.
Ah, that's too bad.
Yeah, well, it happens to the best of us.
Are you gonna pay a Shiva call?
I don't think there will be a Shiva, Josh.
Why?
Shivas are for Jewish families.
He's
just forget it.
Not Jewish?
All right, if that's what you want, I guess I'll go now.
Yeah. Good night, Cantor.
Night, Rabbi.
Cantor. Oh, I just automatically went back in there. I want to look up Lauder. $10,000. Less than 20 minutes ago, I had accepted defeat. The bank was going to foreclose on the property, and there was nothing I could do. Jack's money changed all that. The B'nai Ben Zion Synagogue could remain open. I wouldn't have to see my life's work turned into a shopping mall or a parking lot.
Has God answered my prayers?
The age-old question. What is the work of God, and what is the work of man? The money was a boon, there was no doubt about that. But it was blood money, and I couldn't believe God would work that way.
I don't like it. Not one bit. Why, Jack? Why me? Why now?
They say God helps those who help themselves. And I had done absolutely nothing to get this money. I didn't trust it. Suddenly, the cantor's words came back to me.
A Shiva call. I can't just barge in unannounced, but I can pay a Shiva call. It's the only way.